A four-pole lab-formed DC shunt generator has a useful flux per pole of 0.07 Weber. The armature winding consists of 440 conductors and the armature resistance is 0.055 ohms. Calculate the terminal voltage when running at 900 rpm if the armature current is 50 amperes. So the given question is of DC shunt generator. So first of all we have to know the what is the circuit of DC shunt generator. So let us draw the circuit first. Like this, this is the circuit of DC shunt generator. You can see a shunt winding here. So in DC shunt generator, this motor acts as a generator. So it will supply the current, that is armature current, I can write IA, will supply to load as well as the field. So I can write IF for field current, I can write IL for load current, and let the armature resistance be RA and let the field resistance be RF. So the armature also will have the generated EMF. So let this be E, represented by E, and let the terminal voltage, will be here across the load, that is V. Let it be V plus minus, I can write like this. And he has already given the values of, that is armature current is, he has 50 amperes he has given, and the value of RA, that is armature resistance, is given as 0.055 ohms. So if we take, write the KVL equation in this loop, okay, that is KVL states that the sum of the voltages inside a closed loop is equal to 0. So I will be taking always second sign, I am going in clockwise direction. So going from here, plus E, so plus minus I will denote it, where current is entering plus and where current is leaving I denote it as minus, and I am taking, as I said, second sign. So minus IA into RA, that is voltage. KVL means writing the voltages, so voltage will be I into R, so that's why IA into RA. Coming here, V is there, so second sign is minus here as I go clockwise. So minus V is equal to 0. This completes this loop. Or I can write that E is equal to V plus IA RA. So this is the equation for generator, shunt generator. So we know this RA, we know IA also. We have to find the terminal voltage V. We don't know E also, that is generated EMF, we don't know, but we can find it out. So we know that in DC machine that E is proportional to phi omega, and if I remove this proportionality, it will be E is equal to K phi omega, where omega is angular speed of the rotor, omega R I can write. So if I break this up, so I will get K is equal to PZ by 2 phi A, where P is number of poles, Z is number of total number of conductors, A is number of parallel paths, that is number of parallel path when lap wound is equal to the number of poles, and when wave wound is equal to 2, always remember this. And phi P is flux per pole, and 2 pi n by 60, that is I have converted angular speed to mechanical speed, that is I have converted radians per second to RPM. Okay, now n is in RPM, because the question, in the question he has given in speed in RPM. Now this 2 pi gets cancelled, and the final equation will be remaining with n phi zv by 60. So let us substitute all the values we have like this, and this 4 and this 4 gets cancelled. Now E will be, let's calculate in calculator. So I am getting 462 volts. So E, that is generated EMF, is equal to 462 volts. Now let us substitute the value of E here in this equation which we got from here. So I am getting V, that is terminal voltage, is equal to 459.25 volts. Okay, this is our answer. Thank you.